15-year fixed at just 1.75% rate, 1.99% APR, or a 30-year fixed at just 2.25% rate, 2.39% APR, with no title fees, escrow fees, or appraisal fees. Call True Mortgage now at 800-790-4445. That's 800-790-4445. 800-790-4445. Or visit TrueNow.com. Sign on the line named DBA True Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Terms and conditions apply. All loans subject to underwriting approval and not all applicants will qualify. Loans made or arranged pursuant to a California finance law. License number 60DB044713. NMLS number 1626699.
With PatriotSoftware.com. Accounting and payroll. Keep your time and money. Mike Campbell here, serial entrepreneur. My second business was open 6 days a week and I worked from home the seventh day. I maintained that ridiculous schedule for 8 years. One Saturday morning in 1999, I woke up late for work and was greeted by my six-year-old.
Oh, hi, Dad. Why aren't you at work?
I answered, because it's Saturday. He said,
oh, thanks for visiting, Dad.
His words pierced my heart. I had become a workaholic. It was decision time. What's more important, family or work? I chose family and I stopped working 7 days a week. That's why I created Patriot Software, so entrepreneurs can run their payroll in minutes, which gives more time for their families. Go to PatriotSoftware.com. Use promo code RADIO and get 2 months of payroll processing free. That's PatriotSoftware.com.
It's totally normal to be constipated with belly pain, straining, and bloating again and again. No way.
You could have a chronic condition called irritable bowel syndrome with constipation, or IBS-C. Linzess or linaclotide is a prescription that treats IBS-C in adults. Linzess works differently than laxatives to help relieve belly pain and let you have more frequent and complete bowel movement. Individual results may vary. Do not give to children less than 6, and it should not be given to children 6 to less than 18. It may harm them. Do not take Linzess if you have a bowel blockage. Get immediate help if you develop unusual or severe stomach pain, especially with bloody or black stool. Side effect is diarrhea, sometimes severe. If it's severe, stop taking Linzess and call your doctor right away. Other side effects include gas, stomach area pain, or swelling. Talk to your doctor today. You may be able to save on Linzess and make fewer trips to the pharmacy. See if you're eligible to pay as little as $30 for 90 days. Visit Linzess.com or call 1-800-LINZESS. Sponsored by Abbey and Ironwood Pharmaceuticals.
This is Southern California's only 24-hour local news and traffic station. KLX 1070 News Radio. Good afternoon, I'm Chris Seaton.
And I'm Karen Adams. Our top story at 2:30. President Biden has just announced an increase in the number of distributed vaccines, allowing millions more people to get shots sooner than anticipated.
The weekly supply to states, tribes, and territories will increase from 8.6 million doses to a minimum 10 million. We have in-depth team coverage on KLX, the latest now, at 2:31.
CBS News Special Report. President Biden has just announced the boosting of the weekly supply of COVID-19 vaccine doses for all states and territories.
This will allow millions of more Americans to get vaccinated sooner than previously anticipated.
The president broke down the numbers.
We will increase overall weekly vaccination distribution to states, tribes, and territories from 8.6 million doses to a minimum of 10 million doses. Starting next week, that's an increase of 1.4 million doses per week.
White House correspondent Stephen Portnoy.
New order of 4 doses now should mean enough to vaccinate 300 million Americans by this summer. Biden administration also vows to provide clearer data to states 3 weeks ahead so they can better plan for shipments.
Multiple state officials working for Democratic and Republican governors expressed relief to CBS News about the increased supply of vaccines. CBS News Special Report. I'm Matt Piper.
2:32. As the coronavirus statistics trend downward right now and the stay-at-home order has been lifted across California, the state's government operations secretary, Yolanda Richardson, says they're focused on boosting daily vaccination rates and helping Californians cut through the conflicting information out there.
Californians were understandably confused by mixed messages, variability of eligibility across the state, when it's my turn, who's going next. And so yesterday, the governor announced a statewide eligibility framework that will make it easier for Californians to understand who is eligible to make an appointment to get vaccinated.
It's called My Turn, and is ready now in L.A. County and statewide by mid-February. You can sign up for an alert on when it's your turn to get vaccinated, and for those who've already had their first dose, An alert will be sent when it's time for the second shot. And you can get all the information on our website, knx1070.com.
It's 2:33 now, and health officials say just because businesses are reopening in Los Angeles County does not mean people should be letting their guard down.
Addressing the Board of Supervisors, County Public Health Director Barbara Ferrer said there are still a lot of people in hospitals and a lot of people passing infections from themselves to others, many of them asymptomatic.
And unfortunately, we'll see a lot more people die over the next few weeks. So we're going to have to ask everyone to really stay with this program.
For those business sectors reopening, Ferrer said compliance will be key.
Our health inspectors will be out and about trying to make sure that everyone is doing their part to protect workers and customers.
She said they will be moving swiftly to issue citations at locations where the rules are not being followed. Ferrer added that they just do not have any leeway here to make a lot of mistakes. Margaret Carrero, KNX 1070 News Radio. A year ago today, the first confirmed novel coronavirus case was announced here in LA County. At the time, the person was identified only as a returning traveler from Wuhan, China, one of only four cases reported in the U.S., and county public health officials said then there was no immediate threat to the general public. No special precautions were required.
I don't come down too hard when it's 2020 hindsight, because 2020 is medical now, isn't it?
U.S. virologist Paula Campbell.
I don't think anybody would have anticipated how devastating this coronavirus has been for being.
Over the past year, more than 1 million people in L.A. County have tested positive for COVID-19, and well over 15,000 have died.
You know, in terms of just coming up with raw numbers of how many people are infected, no, we may never know. What we actually care about going forward is that we get people vaccinated, and this includes